What you see here is a brand new three-striped mud turtle hatchling, still toting its yolk sac, sitting on top of a heater. Notice that the heater has a guard on it. That's very important. Those heaters get very hot when they turn on, and turtles often rest on internal water heaters, so always use heaters that have guards. Here's my hatchling tank. The first thing you'll notice, besides that little cute mud turtle right there, is that it's loaded with plants. There's another one, another turtle. There's two more. And you see plants all over the place, and you can see the turtles hanging in the plants. There's another one, another turtle, sitting on some mopane wood. Looking down here, you can see another turtle hanging in the plants. Plants are very important for turtles in general, but for hatchlings in particular, because it gives them a place to hide, place to rest, and a way to get to the surface without swimming. And that's even more important with mud turtle hatchlings, which, while they can swim reasonably well, they're probably the poorest swimmers of the water turtle family. A little piece of mopane wood you see there, turtles like to get in there and scratch. You'll see a little of that later in the video. This little fella just crawling along. I use sand substrate. I strongly believe in sand as a substrate. Turtles will dig in it, play in it, bury in it. Gives them something to crawl on with traction, and it looks nice, and it's easy to clean the surface of the sand. Turtles will interact. I've had as many as 7. The first one hatched July 21st, 2010, over the next 2.5 weeks, all together, 5 turtles hatched. 5 eggs laid by my big female mud turtle, Muddy. There's our smallest. That's actually a rescue. That one right there was rescued off the street. I found him while I was walking. These two are a couple of Muddy's babies. Anyway, 5 hatched over 2.5 weeks. They're all great. They're all healthy, but different sizes, of course, because they didn't hatch at the same time. All have terrific appetites. If you give them a lot of cover and a lot of places to hide and rest, shallow water areas where they don't have to be in the deep water all the time, they'll have a good attitude, they'll be happy, they'll be relaxed, they'll be unstressed, and they're more likely to be to have a healthy appetite and to be a lot of fun to watch. Another reason I believe in a lot of plants and is natural, that's a piece of mopane wood there for basking. That's a basket in the center made out of an egg crate surrounded by mesh and filled with very small, loosely packed pieces of moss. The turtles can crawl down in it and hide or come up and sit on top of it. There you see the filter. There's an internal filter there sitting on the bottom with a brick on top to hold it down. Be very careful with filters when you have hatchlings, especially if the hatchling still has a yolk sac. It can get trapped in the filter. Here again, you see a small hatchling hanging in the generous plants. And here's a little cutie looking out at the camera. They're very often camera shy. I can get very close to them, but the camera scares them, as you'll see right here. This is the 7th turtle that we acquired while walking again, rescued off the street, very tiny, and off it goes. This particular one loves to bask. Have no idea why. It's very unusual for mud turtles to bask that much, but they do sometimes bask, and we've got a couple of them that are basking quite a bit. Looks like the same two players here. These videos kind of go back and forth. Altogether, we had 7 turtles. 4 have already been released into the wild, and 3 more will be released in about 1.5 weeks. You see the fellow there, a little guy, sitting in the plants, and they love it. And when they get scared, they can move. This little guy can boogie. I don't know if this is where it happens, where he gets suddenly aware of the camera, becomes frightened, and you can see he'll take off like a shot. They can really, really zip. Now, when you have this many turtles together, I have a fairly good size hatchling tank. It's 2 feet long, so 17 inches in width, and it's the water depth is just over 5 inches. And the turtles do interact, particularly during feeding time. They'll get mean and they'll bite each other. There's never any injury, but they will bite. Right here you can see one noticing the other. Just kind of like, who are you? What are you doing here? But here's some scratching now. Watch this. They kick sand up on their shell and rub their shell against the mopane wood there, or whatever they can get under. As they grow, their scutes start to shed. There he's coming out, he's noticing the camera. The scutes start to shed, they itch, and so they naturally try to scratch. Here we are releasing our hatchlings, the first four. There are seven, and we still have three, which will be released in a week and a half. These little guys are being let go in a swamp area here in Tampa. Two have already hit the water, so I started the video a little late on this. This is the third one, diving under the duckweed, and the fourth one is about to hit the water in just a second. I found a remote part of the swamp, which is far from the road, far from cars, far from people, where I feel these turtles have a really good chance of survival. One of my favorite places to let hatchlings go. Here you can see it's right next to a big piece of rotting wood with ferns growing out of it. It's right on the border of the Hillsborough River here in Tampa. You can see that it's a pretty nice place for a mud turtle to be released. I hope you enjoyed this video.